Hello YouTube. Today we are going to create a media player interaction similar to what we have in Spotify. When a user taps on the play button, the play progress bar will start and will fill the seek bar. The timer also will be updated accordingly. And in Spotify you can see that the left side timer shows the progress and the timer on the right shows the time remaining. So we'll try to rebuild the same. Let's move on to the tutorial. I have already created the layout. It's pretty basic. I have created a short video on our Instagram page. If you want to have a detailed tutorial on how to build the layout, please reach out to me by comments. I can look into that. And first up, we'll create the variable required. We'll start with the one for the start time. And we need two separate variables for minute and seconds. So let's create that. Oh, and did you notice how I neatly tucked them into a collection named time? So this is a cleaner way to organize variables. Now we can create variables for the end time. Similarly, we need two variables, one for minutes and one for seconds. And now we can create alias variables for storing the end time. So we'll call it display end time minutes and display end time soon. We will set the initial value of display end time minutes as end time minutes and of display end time seconds as end time seconds using alias. And you will get a better idea about this once you go into the tutorials. So please hang on. And once the variables are created, we can move on to linking these variables to their respective text layers. Before we move forward, let's duplicate this frame and give it a unique name. This duplication is like our secret ingredient to creating a looping interaction. And yeah, trust me, it will all make sense soon. Yeah, just please hang on. Now we can sprinkle some interaction magic. We'll set it up to trigger after delay, say every 100 milliseconds. During this delay, we'll increment the start time seconds. For the duplicate frame, we will add the interaction after delay to navigate to the initial frame. Let's see the prototype. You can see that seconds got incremented by 1. We want them to go up to 59 seconds. Well, we have got a fix for that. We will go back to the interaction, add an action to navigate to the duplicate frame. Let's try it out. This is working. We will just reduce the delay to 50 milliseconds to make it move faster. You notice that seconds is going past 59 seconds, so let's add a condition. We will move both the actions we created in the earlier step inside the conditional. Yeah, that should do. Okay, now we have fixed that. The text is going till 60 seconds. Now we have to make the play progress animate when the music is played. For that, we have to add a new variable. Let's do that. We will call the number variable as media width. And then link the width of the progress bar to media width. We will do it for both the frames. Now we can add the interaction to increase the width of the player when the timer is getting updated. So for that, we will just create an action to set the variable of media width and increment it by 1 whenever the seconds is less than 60. Let's see how it is working. Okay, so far everything is good. Now when the second is 60, we should increment the minutes, because you know 60 seconds is equal to a minute. You can add a conditional to check when seconds is equal to 60. When it's 60, we will increment the minutes and also set the value of seconds to 0. Now let's see the prototype in action. Yes, it's working. But here I noticed that both start seconds and end seconds are getting updated. Probably I think I linked the text layer to a wrong variable. Let's fix that. Yes, we had linked to a wrong variable. Let's attach it to the correct variable. Yes, that is done. Now we can add action to update the time remaining to 60 minus start time seconds. Yeah, I probably should have named it time remaining, but no worries, we can work with it for now. And we will add the expressions for update in the minutes. Let's check the prototype. We can try to change the duration of the song. Let's set it to 3 minutes. Yeah, that's done. Now we can check the prototype again. You can see the minutes is going more than the total minutes. So let's add a condition to fix that. Yeah, we have added it, and let's see. So far all good, but now you can see that progress bar is not getting fully filled. It should go until the end of the seek bar. For that we had to update the expression to update the media width variable. Okay, now it's going till the end, but you can notice that the minus symbol is not shown when the minutes is 0. For that, we can create a boolean variable to show hide the minus symbol. Then let's create a minus symbol and link the boolean variable to the visibility of the layer. Now we can add the conditional to show hide the layer based on the value of minutes. We will make the same change in the duplicated frame as well. Okay, let's check the prototype. You can see it working. But you can see that probably we had to add a 0 when the number of seconds is less than 10. So that will look better. For that, let's add a 0. Yeah, and now we can create a boolean variable to conditionally show height it based on the value of seconds. So we have added the variable, now we can add the action. So we will add the conditional to check whether the seconds is less than 10. Then if it's less than 10, we will set the value of the boolean variable as true or else false. Yeah, and that's done. Now we can see it in action. Okay, it's working. Whoa, we have got a little progress bar hiccup to sort out. The progress bar is not going till the end. I think we have to make some adjustment to the expression. Let's change this constant to 5.8. You might be wondering how I came up with this number. I have factored in this screen width to come up with this number. I won't get too deep into the numbers here. That's story for another day, and we are keeping it simple today. We are almost there, folks. Time for those finishing touches. Duplicate the frame and remove all the after delay interactions from it. We will link the play button so that the interaction will start only when a user taps on the play button. We can then change the play icon here to pause icon. When a user taps on pause, we can take them back to the first screen. Sorry, by mistake I had chosen a wrong trigger. It should have been on tap instead of drag. Let's tidy that up. You can see that it's working. Now only thing left is just toggle the video playback when we tap on the pause and play button. We can start by selecting the video and unchecking the autoplay option. Then we can add interaction to the pause button to pause the video and play for the play button. So we added all the interactions. I understand that this video might be a bit complex for many of you, especially if you are just getting started with Figma. Please let me know in the comment section about how I can make it easy for you. All suggestions are welcome. And hey, if you are finding the value in this content, please consider subscribing to the channel. It's like a virtual high five and it keeps this video coming your way. Thank you, and I'll catch you on the next video.